What this study is looking at is a brand new way of capturing wind energy, and that is through airborne wind platforms, harvesting platforms that are up in the sky and able to capture much faster winds that are much more consistent.
Coming out of Mark's study, system study, in 2010, we wanted to actually move into a phase where we were actually building prototypes and getting test data. The idea is to have NASA engaged in the technology development and then bring those technologies up to a certain readiness level to be able to push this out into the commercial sector. We're trying to do it in areas where we think NASA can really make a contribution, specifically aerodynamics and control. Just having access to some of the resources here at Langley, like our model shop and the fabrication technicians over there, has been very important. The students themselves bring another perspective to it, and they come up with ideas that I never even thought of. We currently have a 2-kilowatt demonstrator, and I would like to move up to maybe the 10 to 20 kilowatt range. So my goal for the project is to develop a next generation demonstrator that's in a little bit higher power range. Our current demonstrator just calculates the power produced by the velocity of the tether and the force in that tether. We've been measuring it through line speed and tension. But our next phase is to look at converting it to actual electrical power. Right now, we're using a two-line kite. In the next phase, we are looking at single-line configurations where we have onboard flight control, where we can use one tether line and then flaps or rudders on the vehicle to steer the kite. NASA can also use these technologies for other applications like space exploration. So we're trying to look at applications of airborne wind for platforms that would be used for Mars exploration.